Let's clap our hands for Jesus. Talk to my dita motoma. Now we stand on say no do.
Since I've changed my way, life to honor the anointing of the house.
Tizi to honor say no do.
The most high grace of the house. The grace of Father Apostle.
The miracle prophetess.
And my mother, the prophetess. May God meet them by grace and see him with his face. Let's clap hands for God somebody. We are about to worship God. We are that part of worship God. Part which doesn't need you. Part which needs you and God who created you. Part which glorifies you. But part which needs you and God. Let me tell you what the word of God says in the book of John. It says that time will come. And this is the time that the true worshipers, they will pray in spirit. And when they are in the truth, this is the right time.
Your head. While we are
going to welcome the anointing inside. While we are going to welcome the pastor
God,
pastor
who
is going to give us the word of today. We are talking about a pastor who is educated. We are talking about a pastor who knows who is successful. But when he
hears
the word call of God,
the the word of God. I learned the theme of this conference, whereby there is a scripture written by Paul to the church of Corinth. And Corinth, at the church of Corinth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, in the meantime, we are supposed to be teaching one another, isn't it? Hallelujah. So, when he said,
Musi achiamba,
what did he say?
What do you mean?
What did he say?
Bomba zifio.
He meant the book. What did he say? The thing that is related to, because I want to understand your link with the vision of this church. You've forgotten the thing. I also forgot. Is it 2 Corinthians? 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 17. It says, he who is in Christ
is
a new creation. All things have passed away. So I want to take you through that, but I will be reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 30. There are many verses, but we'll start from verse 27 to the last verse, which is 43. That is the servant of God. That is the verses that were bothering me throughout when I was preparing to come here. I even told God to say, I have never preached about this. You need to intervene in me. The Spirit of God must intervene. Because if it's me who will be preaching about this, I will never give you anything. But the Spirit of God is the one who is going to give you something. And that something is going to transform your life for the rest of your life. Paul says, he who is in Christ is a new creation. You are no longer like before. Immediately when you receive Christ Jesus, you are a new creation. And if you don't bear in mind of this scripture, you will remain as an old somebody, and you will be in the old. You will be presenting with the old. Sometimes you will be imitating your mother, imitating your sister, imitating your son, your father, imitating whosoever is around you, because you are not renewed. But Paul said, he who is in him, in Christ, is a new creation. You are not somebody old. When you talk of old, I'm not talking about the age, because the Bible says, we renew our strength, even when we are old.
God.
The old will never take you anywhere. The shame of the things of the past. I very best to you. I poisonous to you. And so it means you must allow God to renew you. Something you must renew. And you must renew every day. That are there to assist you, to remain in you, because they are always in you. One of them is the anointed, is the anointed. God, use the old anointing, use the new anointing. Every day when you wake up in the morning, use the new anointing. But the new anointing comes with revelations.
The anointing of God.
It takes anointing.
Yeah,
to get inside and go outside. La braza talaba. The disciples of Jesus, when Jesus was about to go, he called them into the upper room and he said, let's meet them. And when he was there with the disciples, he gave them something that will keep on renewing them. That is the Holy Spirit. It's came upon their heads like a flame of fire. It's not necessary that you worship like yesterday. This is a new day. When you worship, it must be a new day.
Hallelujah.
La grazata la ba, shata la ba, handa kasa, ndelewe kezata la ba, la brazata la. When you are ignoring the new anointing, you fail to even to stand up when the anointing is there. Anointing needs people who honor it. The anointing you honor will work for you. The anointing you honor will work for you.
Come on.
Amen. Let us attend. Shatalaba, abalimi gachitu, sinalawe diova, abalimi gachitalawe,
sinalawe.
People,
bring our back.
challenging us with offering.
When
we are waiting,
let us
be, let us be renewed. And technologically, let us do something about this issue of saying I don't tithe, I don't give offering. Let us do something. There are debits, you know. There are debits. We call debts mine. There are some other means of making sure that every month you are giving your tithe. Go to the bank and open a step order. You mustn't bother anybody.
Amen.
Order.
There are the things that makes people to eat you. All the that I want to tell you is only one.
But
you
see,
you can live without food, but you cannot live without water. You can live without food, but you cannot live without water. So it means water is not necessary. Food is not necessary. What is necessary is the water. The research says, with water, you starve yourself and never drink water for 60 days. You are dead. But you can starve yourself and never eat food. But you will never die. You will only have a condition. Which is called anorexia nervosa.
Amen.
Bible says it.
Yeah,
anorexia nervosa.
Anorexia nervosa.
That is the condition that comes if you starve yourself and never eat. But with the issue of water, you die. So God wanted to preserve, because God, our God, is a preserver. When He says we must do this and that, when He gives us instructions, He wants to preserve us. The moment we don't listen, we are calling the enemy to come and attack. So Elijah went to sit next to the river so that he can maintain his life, because there is water. And then God realized, because another name of God, Jehovah, is Jehovah Jireh. And he sent a raven.
Raven.
I didn't know raven in the meaning of Jehovah. Fungu. He sent the raven. And the raven came and provided with food.
Food
you can be given, but with water nobody can give you. We are talking of spiritual things here. And then he survived. And when God realized that now he needs some other type of food, he sent a man into the village. And he entered the village. And then while he was entering the village, he met a woman who was looking after the wood, so that he can go and make a bread for the last time. For the last time, to eat with the son. And then the man of God said, because we are the representative of the kingdom. When we give you order, it's just like the order from heaven. And then the man of God said, go and make a bread for me. Let me eat first. The problem that you have is nothing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then that woman did followed the order. And then the bread that the flour that she had, it never came to get finished. He who is in Christ is a new creation. Jacob is the boy. That was given an order to say, go to my forefathers. But he is your uncle there. And then when he arrived there, everything was prepared. He never got get lost. When you follow instructions for you to be renewed, you will never get lost. You will never go astray. He immediately, when he was next to the stream, Shima.
Shima, okay.
They came.
Ah, Africa.
They came. Some other. Hey, so, those who are looking after the heads of cattle.
But they were
And then it was like when the person who first arrived, it was a lady. She couldn't get the water from the stream. From the borehole, I mean to say, yes.
Okay,
borehole.
Okay.
Because long time ago, when they get water within the borehole, even here, when they used to use a bucket. They tie with a rope and the bucket down and bring water.
Okay.
That's how it was like during the time of Jacob. And then he realized that this is a woman, cannot do that. And then he said, let me help you. And then after helping, he said, do you know Laban? Do you know Laban? And he said, yes, Laban is my father. And then Laban was the uncle of Jacob. And you see, when you listen to the instructions, things are connected well.
So
the only thing that was happening is that the father saw that this boy, if I don't send him to the forefathers, he will never make it here.
He
will never make it. We, as We stand as your father. So the moment you fail to listen to the instruction, when the father is talking, go astray. Let us focus on the word of God. And then the Bible says, he went there and he was well received. What you must bear in mind is that when Jacob went there, was already established. Because he had the anointing that was in him. Number two, he had the grace, favor, and merited favor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we receive grace, Jesus, we got favor in us. The only thing that we need to do is to celebrate the favor that is in us so that it can provide for us. So, when he was there, favor, what I like most about the favor of God is that it affects even the people around you. I have discovered that I know what I'm talking about. My brother is alive today because of the favor that is in
me.
My mother is still alive because of the favor that is in me. Defense Lock is alive because of the favor that is in me.
Because
not that there are no attackers. Not that there are no vultures. But they are there, but the grace will take you. The favor that is in you, servants of God, will make you to stand the test of time. Don't feel intimidated. You are highly favored and blessed. We are highly favored. I was thinking of the fact that in 2007, when I started the ministry, and realized the standard that we are in. Standard. When we talk of standard, we are not talking about number, we are talking about quality. We are not talking about number.
I am in that email.
Here on earth, there will be nobody who will
pass Shangon,
who
has
accumulated the mighty truth. Who will accumulate? There is nobody who will accumulate the mighty truth.
Oh, tribes
for the rest.
For
we are not surveying
until the end.
Nobody.
How?
Nobody is servant of God.
How?
Church is like a river. Christianity is like a river. When a river, at times the river gets full. Sometimes it is like dry. Go to Letaba River. You will, when you look at Letaba River, you will see the sand on top. It's flowing underneath. That's how a child of God must be.
Never tell us about the number. When you are gossiping,
number doesn't matter.
Not about
what matters is the quality and the standard, the level. When there is a conference like this, we talk of the level. We don't talk about how many were there. Because we know that Wasalina Mariana Wasalina Josepha are not many. Because when God stays a conference, He appoints people who are supposed to be there. You clap hands for yourself because clap your hands for yourself because you are the right person to be here.
Stop looking
at now. It's the time for you to be empowered. So we are talking about He who is in Christ. It's a new creation. All Jesus passed away. We talk of the new things. Jacob, money, then he had another
heir
that was in him. It was a blood error. Because when he was born, he presented with something that was not wanted. That's why there is no special person. There is no special pastor. There is nobody who is right. The only one who is right is the King of Glory, who is right now sitting on the right hand of God, interceding for us so that He must be like Him. We are here to strive towards perfection. That's why sometimes we make some errors. And to err is a human, but God is divine. To err is human, but God is divine. It's an idiom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Why am I saying this? I'm saying this because there are some of the people who are failing to be renewed because of the kind of attitude that they have. When we are in the church,
a
student of God called, we are called to lift up the flag of victory. And that flag can be lifted by as few as possible. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the fruit of the land. Nothing will ever stop you. Because when we are talking of to say He who is in Christ is a new creation, the devil will be still saying you are nothing. But the moment he says so, just lift up the flag of victory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you talking to somebody? So Joseph, Jacob.
Jacob.
He had the favor. But he had the weakness. He was a thief. Jacob means a thief.
Jacob was a thief.
And then that was his blood weakness. When he came to Laban, he had stolen or robbed his brother the birthright. Birthright. And he robbed him the birthright. Is that right? Birthright. Mutanje, let's say Mutanje.
Mutanje.
And then that was what he was.
So look,
here he came to Laban. And then Laban, in 27, Laban is making a confession. I'm not going to read, you will read when you are at home. He's making a confession. And he said, ever since you came here into my house, I see the favor. I am a worshipper of idol. But immediately when you arrived here, I see the favor of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It means what you have, the little that you have when you receive Christ Jesus, can make a difference in your family. If you hang on and never give up, and you serve God with your whole heart, and you listen and obey, you shall eat the good of the land. By the little that you have, God doesn't expect you to be special. He just wants to use the little that you have, so that he renews you for the rest of your life. There is a need for us to be renewed for the rest of your life. So the Bible says, he said, I see favor, and my things are going right. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then Laban was also having the same, because he was the uncle. He had the same thing in his plan. He said to Jacob, if you want to marry my daughter, serve me for 7 years. For 7 years. And Joseph, because when you want things from God, you must have a heart of patience. Let me not like I'm attacking you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must have a heart of patience. And then he served for 7 years. And he was very excited, because in the meantime he fell in love with Rachel. But unfortunately, according to the culture, it was not allowed for him to get Rachel because Leah is married. Leah was supposed to first be married because she was the first born. And then that argument was hidden under. And then the day at which he was handed over the bride, he realized that it's not Rachel, the one whom he sent for, it's Leah. And then he said, I didn't want Leah, I wanted Rachel. And then the other said, serve again 7 years. There are some things at which God will say, do it once and again and again and again. So with our reasoning, just say our reasoning. We have got the tendency of remaining on the old when God is giving us a new thing altogether. Because the order can repeat itself several times. When God will be saying, give, and you will have to give several times. Sometimes we limit ourselves and say, hi, we did
many times.
And then immediately when you do that, you are not prepared into the new things. Because new things are meant for those who are listening to the instructions. So the Bible says, he repeated again and he said, I will serve 7 years.
Here
I can get my beloved. So that I can get my beloved. And then he said 7 years and got Leah. And then after that, the uncle still needed the favor that was on Jacob. Because it made a serious deep cut in the life of Laban. And then there comes the story. Whereby now Laban said to Jacob, see, I want to go around my head.
Nugonyago we are katikoro mata
Kasambilanga.
Kasambilanga, okay.
And then I will pick up what I want.
And
then you will remain with what I have left. That when now that thing that was in the blood was dealing with Jacob. Because some of the things that errors that we are committing, they deal with us at a later stage. That's why now we need to be renewed. Because if ever we are not renewed, those things are going to kill us. And then Jacob realized that he needs to think of the God of his father, Isaac. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then the Bible says, he might, I'm assuming, he might have done that which his father used to do. I am assuming. He did what his father used to do. For the sake of his life. And continue, because already he has got two wives and children. And then the Bible says, he said, no, there's no problem. Go around. It's your head of cattle and whatever, the goats and whatever. Those are your things. So Laban took everything that was the best. Listen to this. The devil took everything that was best in your life. Jesus came and saved you.
Yes,
he wants to restore all that which was stolen. So it means you must abide by what is supposed to be done. You must abide by what is supposed to be done. That's what Jacob saved his life with. And then there comes the anointing that is in him now to pave a way for him. The favor was not effective. There should be something that is better than the favor. That's when now the anointing, because anointing breaks the yoke of the enemy. The anointing breaks the yoke of the enemy. When God is talking, Jesus is talking about renewing you. He wants to give you the anointing so that you can break the yoke of the enemy. It's not that easy. But you need to have the anointing so that you can move.
experience.
That's why I didn't even raise you. I'm
not going to
They have to multiply. Because what was needed now for Jacob
is
for him to multiply. That is also scriptural, because in the same book of Genesis, when God blessed a person, he said, "You must multiply." How do you multiply? You must first strike the anointing that was in you. I'm multiplying because of striking the anointing that is in you. You don't multiply by mixing up things. You multiply by striking the anointing that is in you. That's what Jacob did. He struck the anointing that was in him. The Bible says, immediately it went. Whatsoever that is from God, whatsoever is praiseworthy, whatsoever is so good, is the one that is going to make you to go ahead. You will never go ahead by shortcuts. You will never go ahead by missing things. Strike the anointing that is in you. Strike the anointing that is in you.
They
are failing to strike the anointing that is in them. Everything that is from God must come out of you. That's why Paul said, "He who is in Christ."
When Christ saved us, he put
in something that is the world cannot take. That's why he is worried about those who are saved. Because he knows that if they are following the principles of God right, nothing is going to stop them. We see some other people stuck now. Why are you stuck? Strike the anointing that is in you. So that you
strength, anything that is in you.
God
will give you the style on how to attack. I am about to finish, but let me say some few things. The Bible says,
David
killed Goliath. I'm so sorry. sorry, I'm about to finish, but let me conclude this and wrap up. As you know, the only problem with the attendee manager, they will close themselves.
Now the problem are those who will
close themselves.
The time is too long, but they they don't attend church until it is over.
Hallelujah.
Even
you do that, you are closing the anointing of God will never. Because I'm not defending myself. But when a preacher is standing, there is a releasing of the anointing. The anointing that will assist you in times of need. Hallelujah. So the Bible says, those brothers of Goliath, they were very powerful. When I was here, God was telling me about some few things. Let me just tell you.
God is always talking.
Telling me about some few things. I just want you to take note of those few things. The first one, when you want to be renewed, organize yourself. You cannot overcome the enemy without organizing yourself. Outside you are organized. You will be mismatching. But inside yourself, you are not organized. Servants of God, let us organize ourselves. Young men and young women, organize yourself. Mothers, organize yourself. First thing, organize yourself. Number two, know yourself. Why are you in the house of the Lord? Who are you in the house of the Lord? And if you know yourself, you will do that which you know.
You will even do what you know.
There are those who
even need to do what
they know. Those are the things that discourage many people. You cannot do. People will laugh at you if you are out of the church.
And you will run away. And no one will be chasing you.
People can confuse you. When you have even done something wrong, they will congratulate you.
When you know that you were doing wrong,
they will say,
you will get people to encourage you.
If you know yourself, you do best what you know.
But it can be mandas never.
So you need to know yourself so that you can be renewed.
But
number three, walk tall.
But don't chimbira mukha. When you look at what others are doing, you follow them. Others are sitting and also sitting. This one does not good end.
No! For your Christianity.
Come on, it does not really have.
Some of the people will say,
don't know about
what
to do,
right?
We used to do that, now we are tired. But someone catches us now at your bomb. Come on, Timber Mokap.
Plastic.
Others they put their problems in the plastics.
When I hold it by your head and go to church.
Come on, don't you follow my tongue? Is that a man? They are known to mean those who. Yes.
And at the moment you are not walking tall.
Most of us are chipping
your pata. You are stooping low.
The Bamba Koto. Bamba Kotea Bas.
Baba
Kotea Bas.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Walk tall.
Worshipper,
walk tall. Preacher of the word, walk tall.
Servant
of God, let us walk
last thing.
Never look back.
Baso mo sa damra.
Never look back.
Murao baso mo sa
et. Never look back.
Baso mo sa damra.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Encourage yourself like David.
Kama di tutuwas na sa kusa David. Basi sa damrao.
Some of the people.
Bawa na bato.
Are running out from church.
Bako shaba kereke.
Because of the experience that they had in the past.
Ngamulando sa matanga na sa murao.
Some of the experience was good, of course.
Because in the past, we need to cast out the
demons.
We've
got time to empower.
Today, we can't cast out the devil, but we can empower. Why do you want to take us back? Why do you enjoy when you were casting out
the devil? Why are you not enjoying the word of God? You need to enjoy the word of God.
Don't look back. Look ahead. Prepare for the things ahead. That's what Jacob did. When he confronted his uncle, he told him that it's only because I also want to have a
family.
So I know my God will do something. He struck the anointing in him.
And
that anointing worked for him. It worked for him to understand when he goes out. He had a multitude of goats and sheep and
Cattle.
And the brothers of Rachel. They were very worried and they started to gossip about him. They wanted to kill him. And then he got out of Laban's house and go and establish himself. Good people,
what's wrong?
God wants to renew us. First thing, when he wants to renew us, we must be on our own.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on,
according to how
other people are.
God said, according to how
people are.
Send God diligently. In your whole, with your whole heart. And humble yourself. God will raise up in due time. He who is in Christ.
Oh, no, you are
a new creation.
Oh, no,
let him be with the brothers of Goliath.
Sometimes
the enemy copy what you are doing.
So
they can attack you. So what is needed is that when you must always be renewed.
So
will be using old tricks to a wrong person. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So those guys were really, really well established. The servants of David also
were
ascending up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were up, at above the brothers of Goliath. The Bible says, and they're using bow and arrow.
Empowerment
that they had. When God says you must be renewed, because he knows.
You will decide to stand.
And it is not the time to stand.
And
the time for us to move on.
Don't
look back. Don't ever think about anybody else. Take care of yourself. And make sure that you are organized to serve God. To serve God. Irrespective of what is happening.